two, one, two, three, four. On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again.
Welcome, everybody. Lots going on around here today. Lots of activity. I'll get down to the shop here and let John Fix explain to you what's going on. But while you're down in the shop, beware of the pits.
Got something a little different today. Yeah, I do have some more really unusual tools to show you, but not today. Gonna have some fun today, calling this segment Odds and Ends. I've got some redos on a couple of tools I've done before to make some major improvements to them. And I've got a couple of new items for you to show you today. So we get on now with the Odds and Ends show. Well, sometimes you think you got it right, sometimes you don't. I kept looking at this old tool that I just refinished, and I put this pine handle on it that I made, and it just wasn't right. I don't know what it was about it, my mood at the time or what, so I finally got the old finish handle, the old handle, done correctly. Lots of sanding, lots of smoothing. I put a gunstock finish on it, which I just bought. I haven't had gunstock before, and I guess I wanted to try it out. But now the handle looks more natural. Looks like it goes with the tool better. So redid it one last time to get the final touch on it. Here's an interesting little item, a tack puller, nail puller. So small, I think of it more as a tack puller. Can't find a name on here. May uncover something in here once I get it cleaned off. Got a nice wood handle on it to be refinished. We'll get to work on restoring this. Well, so far no luck getting down in here with the wire wheel, of course. I'll have to do it the old-fashioned way with a wire brush by hand. Well, now that the handle's been scraped and sanded, and I put a stain on it, turns out the wood had a nice grain to it, which I could not see before putting the stain on there. It's amazing what that brought out. So we'll finish this out. It's still got to dry, and then we'll put a finish on it to preserve the stain, and we'll have a nice little item once it's finished. The little tack puller was in good shape structurally, everything was sound. It just needed a complete restoration, refreshing. We're just old and dingy. So here's what we did to give it a new life. I was pleasantly surprised when I cleaned the wood on here. It had a nice grain, not huge pronounced grain, but it had a nice grain to it. So I chose a little lighter color stain to put on here, and as you can see, made a tremendous difference in the appearance on this item. All the metal was just wire brushed and buffed with steel wool, the natural metal look, and then of course the handle redone, restained and polished, and really a nice improvement. Another item I acquired lately was this Irwin screwdriver was actually a government stock edition. It's got the government stock number on there. You'll see it better when it's cleaned up. But the handle, of course, finish was bad, and the metal was dingy and pitted, and the tip had a lot of pitting in it, so I was quite concerned about getting this tip done right, because the pitting was pretty extensive and pretty deep on both sides, so it's going to take some work there. Also, I needed to maintain that Irwin name and the government stock information that's on here. I didn't do a before video. All I've got is this picture. Thank goodness I took a picture. I somehow just completely escaped me doing a video. Didn't think about it. I just dove right into fixing it up. So let me go ahead and show you what we did. And there's the redone item. Looks very nice compared to what we had. The handle I redid in a nice color, finished it out. It was in good shape, tightened it up, sanded it down, restained it, and finished it. All the metal was cleaned all over, sanded and wire brushed, and of course put on my fiber belt. But you can see the name on it there, Irwin USA, US of A, the way they did it. Government stock number 41-8-1076, I think. See if we can, I don't think it'll. Yeah. I can see it better through here, too. 41-8-1076, government stock. So, very unusual item because of the government identification number on there. And oh, the tip I told you about. Almost perfect, not completely, mainly because if you look at the width of it now, I really had to remove a lot of material to get that pitting out. So it was getting awful thin. I had to finally stop. So you'll see some little remnants of some pitting on here. Not a lot, but something I don't usually like to have, but I couldn't keep going. I couldn't keep on going anymore. That was enough. And another nice screwdriver for the collection. You know, I love the screwdrivers. I like to refinish the metal and the wood. So there it is, all redone and a major improvement over what I bought. Next is a crate tool I did some time ago, and I just wasn't completely happy with it. It's one of those I keep looking at and looking at and looking at and saying, I just could have done better on this. Although I took a really ugly, terrible tool and turned it into a nice item. And that's one where I made the handle out of a piece of oak. And so I was quite proud of that. But I don't really like the light finish on there. It was a little light for some reason. I don't know. I like the darker wood. And I didn't like the shine that was on this part. So I said, well, heck, let me just work on it some more. Give it a little bit more work. So here's what I did to improve it. And I like what I did. I took that handle and put a gun stock finish. Took all the finish off, sanded it. Put that new gun stock stain that I have on there. And, of course, you know, natural oak with that stain on it is just beautiful. Now I'm happy. That grain really shows here. It was sort of muted and light. And it just shows up beautiful now. Beautiful grain. And, of course, when I did this handle, I made it by sandwiching a piece of metal in between the scales. So it looks like the original handle that was on here. There were scales that were, that metal looks like the original handle that was on here, but it wasn't. It was a piece of metal that I added to give it that look. And as far as the shine on it, I went back and started resanding and went down up through the grits and got it really smoothed down, then put it on the fiber belt. And one thing I did recently, I wasn't getting good results, and I looked at that fiber belt I was using, and it's about 6 months old, if not older. It just wasn't doing much anymore. So I put a new fiber belt on and was able to get some good shine to the head of this tool. So I'm happy with it now. Sometimes the redos, you just need to do. I needed to do for my own benefit because I just wasn't happy with what I had here. And I think we came up with the right item now. The last item to finish up the odds and ends. This made me feel like a scout crafter. This looks like something he would do. In the original box, new old stock. Screwdriver set with built-in light. DD Imports. New York, New York, a lighted screwdriver compact kit. You know, the graphics in the boxes, they don't make them this way anymore. And inside the box, we've got a nice little case. It's vinyl. You open it up and you've got the screwdriver along with four bits, two Phillips, two slotted bits. And here's the item itself. Beautiful condition, really new old stock. This has not been used at all that I can tell. And of course it's, you can see the light on it, it's lighted. And what you do is, like you do with any screwdriver bit holder, got a little chuck on the end, you put it in, tighten it up, and you've got your screwdriver. And if you're in some work, let me kill the light back a little here and see what we can get. Yeah, that's a little darker. So if you need a little bit more light on your work, now you've got a lighted screwdriver, kind of like on the cordless ones now where they have the lights built in. This is a cordless screwdriver. Runs off a battery, just like the new ones. And it's got the light. So all I did later was add a motor. This is the motor. I don't know what this sold for originally. I tried to find some information on this kit. Could not find any information online. I did find some other kits like this. And I don't think many of them would be in this condition. Just got a chrome finish on here. It's not plastic with chrome, it is metal. And the light. So, an interesting little item, and again, it made me feel like Scout Crafter doing one of his show and tells. In fact, it wouldn't surprise me at all if he had one of these. I don't know what he doesn't have, and he seems to have a lot of items like this in their original boxes that he might have purchased himself a long time ago. Well, that concludes the odds and ends for today. No heavy duty major corroded tools brought to renew with repairs and lots of work on them. Just some lighter duty items. Sometimes you just need a little break, and again, you just need to do something to please yourself. It's something I had fun doing because I was able to take a couple of tools and get them to the standard that I always wanted. I never got there when I originally did them. This new nice Irwin government stock tool, the little tack puller, looking sharp now, and the screwdriver set. So something a little different today with the odds and ends. I hope you enjoyed the video.